Hello viewers, welcome to another session of my pharmacology series. So today I'll be talking about the drugs which are acting as the skeletal muscle relaxants. So particularly we are going to deal with the classification of the drugs which are acting as skeletal muscle relaxants. So when talking of these drugs, there are basically one is the central muscle relaxants and the other class of drugs are the peripheral muscle relaxants. So the first, the central muscle relaxants, if we are going to look at the classification, we can easily remember the classification of these drugs in just if we do remember the initials of the letters central muscle relaxants, that is the C, M and R. So the drugs what are used here is the first class of drugs comprises of the C, that is C of the central is going to correspond to the drugs that is the carisoprodol, chlorzoxazone and chlormizanone. So the M of the muscle relaxant stands for the mifensin and the meprobamate group, and the R stands for, we can remember the class of the drugs belonging to the R category is the receptor acting drugs which are going to increase the GABAergic transmission. That is going to act on those neurons which is going to affect the transmission of the neurotransmitter gamma-aminobutyric acid. So under the category of the R, we are going to have the two B's, that is the benzodiazepines, which act on the benzodiazepine receptors linked with the GABA A receptors. And next is the baclofen, which is going to act on the GABA B receptors. So the classification of the drugs can be better remembered if we just remember the initials of the central muscle relaxants, that is C, M and R, by just remembering the initials, that is C, it is going to correspond to the three C's over here. As I have said, the M stands for the two M's, that is mifensin and meprobamate, and R is going comprising of the two B's, that is the benzodiazepine and the baclofen. So just a short look at the clinical uses of such drugs. So the clinical implications of the skeletal muscle relaxant, when talking of the clinical uses, can be visualized if we simply remember again the short term C, M and R, that is the central muscle relaxants. So particularly the C of the central muscle relaxant, it is the clinical uses comprises of in dealing with the CNS disorders associated with the spasticity. Example in patients of hemiplegia, paraplegia and multiple sclerosis, which is a demyelinating disease of the neurons, and in cerebral palsy. The next use of the central muscle relaxant, that is the M, corresponds to the manipulations in orthopedics, example in setting of fractures and dislocations, and R will be talking, R is going to, the clinical uses belonging to this, if we remember R, is in relieving the muscle spasm. What kind of muscle spasm, which I have summarized under the four T's, that is trauma, tetanus, tension and torticollis. And they are can also be used in treatment of anxiety. So viewers, this was my short trick or the mnemonic as to how we can easily remember the classes of the drugs of the central muscle relaxants in the form of a simple short trick or a mnemonic. That is the C, M and R. We can remember the classification of the drugs by just remembering CMR, and the clinical uses also we can better remember if we just remember the short term C, M and R of the central muscle relaxants. So viewers, if you do like my video, please subscribe my channel and do press the bell icon so that you can be further updated about my newer videos. Thank you for watching.